2016 has proven to be a bit of a difficult year. A lot of cool people died, Trump and Pence got elected, there was Brexit, a refugee crisis, the Zika virus, just to name a few things that made the last 366 days a little bit hard to stomach. But there were also quite a few incredibly awesome scientific advancements and technological breakthroughs that made this year stand out. So in spite of a negativity bias that's so common in the media, I want to take a look at the positive things that really made this year stand out in a good way. Let's end on a positive note, shall we? This year, scientists began utilizing a method for targeted gene manipulation. The method, known as CRISPR, allows scientists to target specific genes that they want to change, and then go in and alter only those genes in a matter of days. So freaking cool. Think about the ramifications of this. That means that not only can we create new antibiotics, but we could cure diseases and even create crops that are resistant to drought. Researchers at Stanford were able to inject stem cells into the brains of paralyzed stroke victims, enabling them to walk again. That's freaking cool, but it gets even better. They speculate that the same treatment could possibly be used to treat Lou Gehrig's, Alzheimer's, and even Parkinson's. Yay, science. There were two major breakthroughs in fertility treatments this year that really stood out. First, mouse stem cells were turned into fertile eggs, which then became living offspring. Cool stuff in the realm of stem cell research. And second, after a couple tried and failed multiple times to have a healthy child, doctors discovered that there was a rare disease being passed on to the child through the mother's mitochondrial DNA. Now, because mitochondrial DNA only passes through the ova and not the sperm, we all have identical mitochondrial DNA to our moms. In order to overcome this obstacle, doctors took healthy mitochondrial DNA from a third patient and combined it with the mother's egg, fertilizing it with the father's sperm and creating the first child with three parents. The Tesla Gigawatt 1 factory opened this year, pushing us one step closer to a world of clean renewable energy. And in other Elon Musk news, SpaceX was able to successfully launch a rocket into space, bring it back down, and land it on a platform in the middle of the ocean, upright. How freaking cool is that? Solar Impulse 2 becomes the first solar-powered plane to complete a trip all the way around the globe. And we sequenced the genome of the tardigrade, and potentially found a way to make humans more resistant to radiation in the process. We kicked Ebola's butt and found a vaccine for it, and we found a potential vaccine for HIV as well. Lab-grown lungs were successfully transplanted in mice. Berkeley created a parkour robot. We discovered an exoplanet about the size of Earth orbiting our closest neighbor star within the inhabitable Goldilocks zone. Using new 3D imaging techniques on the last 20 years of Hubble's photographs, scientists were able to determine that the universe is 10 times bigger than previously expected. After a chip was implanted in his brain, a quadriplegic was able to successfully perform complex hand motions, including swiping credit cards and even playing Guitar Hero. Scientists in Iceland were able to use a new carbon sequestration method to pull carbon dioxide out of the atmosphere and pump it into the ground. And to top off this list, scientists at LIGO were able to detect gravitational waves for the first time, not once, but twice, proving Einstein right 100 years after he made his initial predictions. I know I was only able to cover a fraction of the cool stuff that happened this year, so I'm gonna try to put together a bigger list on my blog. What were your favorite moments of 2016? Be sure to comment below in the little area thing, doobly-doo, whatever it's called. Let me know. Also, if you know someone that's been having a really crappy year, feel free to shoot them this video. Maybe it'll help cheer them up and spread a little optimism. And in order to help combat some of the negativity bias that the media has, I really recommend that you check out a book called Abundance by Peter Diamandis. It's amazing. The future is so much brighter than we think. Happy 2017, everybody. I hope that your next year is even better than this one. Consider giving this video a thumbs up if you liked it, subscribe if you want more, share it around if you'd like to see this channel grow. If you want to help me out financially, support me on Patreon on a per episode basis. You can cap how much you want to pay each month, you know, it's okay. Every dollar helps a lot. So yeah, have a great new year, and I will see you in the next video. Don't drink the Kool-Aid. Please like and share this, and support me on Patreon if you can. Y'all rock.